And you see, so Doc Stevens is like, okay. He's got the, you know, the clipboard going. He's like,
do I get a lollipop after?
Lollipop or fresh out, my friend.
Oh, well then this day is just the worst.
All right, now, what do we got here? What's your name?
My name's Yosef.
Yosef? All right. And Jose. Boy, oh boy. Alice, you're going to probably want to get the suture kit on this one. And,
I want little lightning bolts.
Oh. Stupid.
You know, he gets a little chuckle there. He's like, And what do we got here? What's your name, son? And then you got Ray. Okay. You took one hell of a beating. And we got, what's your name? Mike. And it's like, okay, cool. Mm-hmm. And then I think, is that ever? Oh, what's your name? Brian. But he, you know, it's very shallow breathing. Like,
stop, Brian.
All right, we're going to have to take an extra look at you. Okay, now, so we're going to get started with you there, and, well, let's take a look here. And, we're going to roll you over, by the looks of it, it's on the backside, the wound. Now, what happened to your knee?
Well, there's this guy that I'm going to kill that's with us.
Well, unfortunately, your murderous intentions are going to have to wait. You're under my watch.
No, man, get me right, it's raining. Give him the pain.
Two parallel stories. Eight adventurers. Will they collide? Starring Connor.
I'm gonna just give you some food for it.
Danny.
Do it.
Devin.
You can go to five or six stores, or just one.
Ryan. Nick. Ryan.
Fill the wall.
Nathan.
Pain.
Brandon. This is The Walking Dead, Dungeons and Dragons, Season 4.
There's some strict rules against that sort of stuff here.
No, but man, I'm going to have a good chat with the Patriots about it.
We tend to look down on murderers here.
It's not murder, man. He stabbed me.
This ain't the proud reason. The big cities you grew up.
Whatever makes you happy inside, I suppose. But, you know,
it's not about being happy, it's about being right.
We're against death around these parts.
Well, you know, chances are you probably could actually pull something with the Major. He likes to partake in some of that sort of stuff, so...
We used to hunt man for sport.
And, well, the military guys are like, you shut your mouth, doctor. And he's like, all right, roll over. And, so they roll you over, and they begin the examination process.
Roll over that D20.
Inspect that butthole.
One.
And so.
You fall on the floor.
So, yes, so the grand
roll
tour.
Roll to see how cold your doctor's fingers are.
And so, Abraham, what would you like to do after talking with the
military guys? Is it grosser
guys?
If they're warm?
You want slightly above body temperature so that it matches when you go down and up.
Anyway. In and up.
So, what would you like to do after discussing with the military?
What else is there to do? I'll check out on the rest of the gang, I guess.
Okay. Got board games.
So, yeah, you're going to go search about. And, well, the military guys start wheeling away the bucket of guns and stuff. And
can
they
I
leave.
Watch where they take it?
Sure, yeah.
Just, like, directly follow them.
Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, you'd have to roll a stealth check just to see how nonchalant you are right now.
17,
nice.
You are cool cucumber, sir.
Yeah, you sort of pass it out as if you're walking down the street, but you know, you're glancing, you're catching, and you see the wheelies into the what was labeled as the armory. You see one of the guards move out of the way, and the door opens up, and they wheel it in, and the guy goes back in front, and and then you see Philip. You also see Philip, he looks around, and he lifts up the trunk, and he starts pulling out bags of goods, like some of the canned goods you guys gathered up earlier, like the jerry cans, and the bags of food from the cellar. Mm. So yeah, he just starts throwing all that stuff in the, into the box, yeah, into like the wheel box. Yeah. And anything else you'd like to do?
I'll just keep an eye on Philip for now.
Okay. And he empties out everything in the box, and he starts wheeling it down the street. Yeah. Towards one of the buildings, because he doesn't really know where he's going, so he's just gonna sort of wheel it and get directions. Yeah.
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 That was a lot less inconspicuous than I wanted to. You're at 31%, I'm at 6.
We're experiencing technical difficulties. Please stay tuned.
So,
at 31%.
Yes. What would you guys like to do? So, of course, yeah, so you're following around this this group of strangers, as it were.
What's your fucking... That could have been a lot less painful, James, if your computer didn't make sound.
So, I guess I'll go with the Connors character.
Okay.
So what kind of stuff you've been through?
Well,
yeah, well, I had to change mine.
What most people have gone through, but
who?
I'm more
change it again.
Just the,
Who did your hair?
I did.
Probably nice. 10 or 15 feet away from it at all times. I've never really experienced it myself.
Did you hear that last time I was on you?
What's your name?
I am Cole Winter. How about you?
Cut it the
Edward.
Last time, but I cut it again the other day. I cut it in.
Nigma.
This in-game conversation. Yeah.
At a game conversation.
How old are you?
I want to know if it's pedophilia or hebephilia.
You don't need to tell me, but how old does he look?
The ripe age of 23.
Okay.
Oh boy.
I'm like 36. So.
Grizzled.
You're old.
Senior alert.
I'm 26. I'm a grizzled 42.
You're the oldest one here.
So.
Character wise.
How is this town? Was it wild staying up?
It's all right if you keep your head down.
Yes. Wink, wink.
I suppose, to be fair, you've been in the town, of course, for as long as you described earlier there.
Since you was 4.
Yeah. So, of course, you're less exposed, one would say, to the outside environment as compared to these very grizzled-looking... So
warriors.
They've been definitely through a meat grinder and back again, some of them. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, like, I had a gun at the back of my head a few, like...
hours ago. I had a knife in my back.
Yeah.
No, like, so you guys know, I am literally
stab
going to kill
back
him in front of everybody.
At your two
blades. Well, I
just
want
you to
all
D&D role.
Have fun.
A bad name.
And I'll tell you this again when I can actually tell you.
There's a better way, Danny.
And so,
take him to court.
Yeah,
zombie court.
No, man, I'm gonna write him out and then kill him.
So Philip walks up to you, and, how do I put this? You're the next worst person I know, besides the prick who killed my daughter.
Hey, I called him prick first, now he's just using my insults.
What did I do to you?
Oh, no, that's a compliment. You should take that as a compliment. If you're offended, I'm sorry, actually. But the thing is...
Backtracking like a boss.
The thing is, he taps the bucket. Thunk, thunk. And he's like, how good are you at keeping quiet?
Pretty good.
I want you to help me.
on a secret mission.
I just want you to keep Detroit occupied while I set up my room.
Where are you setting up your room?
Top floor of that apartment over there. I called it. You just gotta keep Detroit and that other guy out of the way for like 10 minutes tops, and we'll be hunky dunky.
Sure.
From scared. Philip's acting weird. He wants me to keep you guys busy.
And so, he's like, all right, they're just over there at the apartments.
Alright.
So he's a, I'll wait until they're gone. Keeping signal.
Okay.
Yeah. So, So what do you do?
I'll go over and strike them.
Okay. So, you approach Detroit and this other gentleman, as he's giving the tour, and he's like, fuck you, pillow. And he's like, Detroit's like, all right, so this apartment block, sort of the top two floors, haven't been filled out yet, so there's probably some room for you guys to cram in there. So, we should be good, yeah. And, you approach the scene.
I was wondering about what type of rooms these are, and what sort of system you have going on here.
Like, what do you mean?
Like, what is this place?
Well, it's a walled-in town.
Who runs this place?
That would be Major Gene Gap. I think he met you guys.
As in the
bus.
Pants.
I was
Gabby.
The guy.
Okay.
Yeah. He's a keeper, that one. Oh, he extorts the fuck out of the town.
Oh, yeah?
If there was any other way about it, I would be, I would prefer to have someone else in charge, but obviously, I mean, no one stepped up since he killed that guy at the last race, so, yeah. Mm.
So he took over this, town from somebody before?
No, no one really stepped up. He's been in charge since the beginning.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. And,
what's the race?
The race, actually, tomorrow night.
The race of champions.
They have dirt races, like cars and stuff.
Ooh.
Yeah. Yeah, it's loud as shit. Brings walkers every goddamn day.
Because he's stupid.
Yeah, he wants to keep the town occupied and happy, but he also, you know... You have to pay your way to get in.
Hmm.
Forcefully,
even
as well.
It's mandatory.
Yeah. He extorts the shit out of this town. But anyways, I shouldn't be giving our gracious major who saved us all a bad name. Especially when some of his cronies are out and about. So, well, you know what? How about I show you something over here? This is one of the buildings down the street.
Sure.
Yeah. Because you look pretty cop-like.
I was an officer.
Of the law.
That might be half useful around here.
Oh, you were like a fucking... Oh, I thought you meant like... You're like a past officer, and I'm like... Fucking person is an officer, dumbass.
So,
No, I was a police officer, Jesus.
Well, we could actually probably... You could actually be like a really good like... middle ground spot, actually.
Yeah, he's been shot up enough.
Yeah.
Like, he's got experience.
Yeah.
Cool. Anyways,
the more you get shot, the better you are.
All right.
It's so sad that you get killed most of the time, though.
I build up my tolerance.
And so,
my tolerance to bullets.
Small
caliber.
Abrams, you sort of lead Detroit sort of away from the apartments with this conversation, and he's like, all right, everyone, let's just go down over here. And,
okay.
Do you follow with the group there, Edward?
Enigma.
What? Do I follow the group?
Yeah.
Where are they headed again, sir?
They're just going down, continuing the grand tour.
Yeah, I guess I'll go.
Okay, cool. And, so you guys proceed down the street, and,
So
the tour continues.
Good.
The coconut?
Yeah. But it's like, it almost tastes like fake coconut.
Yeah, well, it probably is. And, we'll be back after the break. And we are...
Here we go.
And, so the tour has ended. You guys have been sort of designated your apartment, sort of ask So, is there anything you'd like to do before the sort of the day sort of folds a little bit? Is there anything?
Well,
is
if it's gonna fold, I want to raise.
Cause yeah, I mean, you got this whole town to explore. You got all sorts of stuff. You'd be able to do.
You got people to kill. I mean, you can do anything.
Do anything.
Because there's, of course, you know, there's this armory, the cafe, the food store, the tool mechanic, the garden, the stadium.
The tool mechanic. Yeah, he's a real tool.
Yeah.
The screwball.
And you got the town hall, the apartments, yeah, all sorts of stuff.
Town fool.
Or just like the
majestic village
town
idiot
itself.
And the town drunk. The three of them get together on weekends. They play D&D.
you hear the gunshot go off from the guard towers. There's like in the four quadrants, in the four walls. There's like two guard towers in each. So and one's in the corners as well. So the odd time you hear like a just like one. And then you hear the followed up with a yeah, got him. Yeah,
3 points.
Yeah,
got him.
Very nice.
And so yeah, is there anything you guys like to do in the town?
I need a date of a lot I'd Seuss. Like to do in the residence. There's certainly a lot I'd like to do in the residence.
Okay, so you enter your sort of resident area, and so it's a two-bedroom. It's a two-bedroom. living room, kitchenette. You will be sharing. So you and Helen will be together, along with in this room. Let me check in the character list.
Same room.
Well, yeah, you two will be in the same room, presumably. Okay. And then there's another bedroom where, presumably, I think who is it? Well, it's not Ray and Mike because they're getting other things. Check here. Yes, okay. So it'll be Andrea and...
That's it.
Who else is... No, yeah, it'll be just Andrea in the other room. Because Brian's getting his own room as requested. Philip has his own room.
Ray, of course, has his own room.
Ray and Mike are... well, they're not sleeping in these apartments.
Oh,
so.
That's a treat, I forgot.
Yeah. And, yeah. So you can dump whatever backpack inventory you had in the house or something so you don't have to carry it anymore with you.
Is there any really not obvious hiding spot that I could put a, let's say, concealed handgun?
You'd have to investigate your apartment.
Okay, I investigate my apartment.
Roll a d20 there, Sonny. Intelligence check.
And then my intelligence is plus 1 to 11.
11 total? Okay. Well, obviously you don't find something extraordinary, but something that sort of enters your mind would be like, ooh, behind the laundromat, maybe?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to keep it in my coat for now. Mm-hmm. But something...
Like a completely different building?
Oh, no, sorry. Laundry machine. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Put it in the dryer lint catcher.
Yes. Because who even needs clean clothes?
Well, you are sharing the apartment with someone, so if they were to use it and...
Yeah, but the probably wouldn't be allowed to use dryers in the post-apocalyptic universe because they take a shit ton of energy.
And
washing machines use a lot of water, which would be in short supply.
So that's... Like, they're not being used.
Well, you don't know that. Do you?
Like, if they're using them, these people are either stupid or, like...
Loaded. This place is lit.
Well, you would have to open up the dryer.
I'm gonna open up the dryer.
Light bulb.
Oh my god.
No, here's the thing. It can be connected, but it doesn't mean to use it.
Okay. I'll keep it in mind. But...
You keep it on your body?
Yeah.
Okay.
This place is lit. Nobody's home.
And so,
I'm gonna kill Philip.
In the infirmary, of course, you've been well taken care of. Your wounds are sutured and stitched to the supremo.
Did you do lightning bolts?
I've done lightning bolts.
And of course, you know, the doc's just like...
Fast.
Yeah. Alice laughs. He's like, you're a funny one, eh?
Well, when you get stabbed, you gotta look at life differently. So am I clear to go?
Yeah, look at life in the behind you.
Can you go?
Yeah.
No?
I got things to do.
You might have things to do, but not until I'm done with you.
Well, that's why I was asking.
Gotta do a full physical as well. The thing is, though, you suffered a massive stab wound. I don't know. You barely missed your kidneys. So I'm just saying.
No, I've only ever had one at the beginning, and anyway, it didn't hit anything.
And you
cancer when I was 14.
Is that really part of your backstory? Okay. Okay. You're really lucky to be alive right now. So you're gonna be staying here for at least a couple nights.
You've only got one kidney.
What?
You only got one kidney.
This is yes.
No, I have both my kidneys.
Oh.
I think I would have told
you. Oh, that was part of your backstory.
No, it wasn't. I was just saying that.
Oh, okay.
Josh.
You think I would have told you at some point if I had cancer?
I don't know, man. I knew a friend who, I had a friend in Florida with, brain cancer and didn't tell me until, for a year.
Fair enough.
And this episode's gone down a dark road.
I probably will have cancer by the next level.
Yeah, most people do.
Well, yeah, I have no...
You're giving it to me now.
Oh!
I have no feeling history.
Just seeing you gives me cancer.
I skim through on so much shit, lucky-ass shit in my life. It's just gonna get hit, with a massive amount of cancer.
Dungeons & Dragons has stolen all your luck.
Yeah, don't die.
Just
yeah,
the thought of seeing
you
gives me cancer.
Dungeons & Dragons, and you have shit luck in real life.
No, I just use my skill in real life.
Which
and,
is zero.
So, Doc Steven says... Can't go until I'm done with you. It's gonna be at least two nights.
Alright.
You can do stuff around here, but you can't leave the infirmary. And I'm always here, so I'll know.
And always watching.
Any, magazines?
Yeah. In the patient room there.
All the kids' highlights you can. What is it? Vogue and...
Reader's Digest.
No. Reader's Digest and Highlights.
Reader's Digest is the biggest friggin' medical thing, but I can't find a fucking, place with them. I'm like, oh, well, I'm bored here at the doctor's office. Might as well open up a Reader's Digest. Fucking none.
You're going to all the ghetto doctor's offices.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, actually, there's a box of Reader's Digest in the room there, so...
You got any Archie or...
You're a man of good taste.
A bathroom?
Alice!
Bombay Vidankanaks.
Can our guest read your Archie collection?
I'm not bleeding anymore. I can't get...
I've never seen an Archie comic outside of the bathroom. Maybe it's just my relatives, but every single bathroom they own...
is an Archie comic.
Oh, yeah. By the coffee table, right next to the handheld Yahtzee game.
Archie's
in their bathrooms.
Yeah.
In their bathroom,
yeah. Number one coffee tables in the bathrooms.
Mm-hmm. Just little tables.
And then the coffee tables, but then they have handheld Yahtzee games, and then Archie.
Yes.
They're spending a shit ton of time in there.
Yes.
Oh, get it?
I don't know. It seems like the older I get, the more time I spend in the bathroom. Just because I take my time.
Yeah, phone, man.
Yeah.
Mm. But to be honest, I'd rather just a quick cleanup and go. Just I don't care. Boss
makes a dollar, I make a dime, so I poop on company time.
I don't want to share that, you bastard.
I thought that way before the memes.
As old as the hills.
Yeah, it's Elmo sitting on the toilet.
Yeah, no, I shared that in our chat.
That thing's been dancing for years. So back from the infirmary.
There's actually an ancient Chinese proverb that's basically a translation of that.
Of course there is.
Emperor makes a dollar, I make a dime. That's why I poop in the rice fields.
Oh.
So,
spreading dysentery.
I shit in the rice fields because it's good for the grain. It's good for the ground.
So, Cole... Abrams, Edward, is there anything you'd like to do before this day wraps up?
Come rescue me. Like, I'm really crippled as far as this game is for the next, like, 2 hours. I'm just gonna go play on my phone.
Go ahead. Because,
just, like, for honesty, like, I really don't have anything to do. Like, I'm not just flipping you off here. Okay.
No more cripples getting be cripples.
Whew. I mean, to be fair, there was someone in a coma last campaign.
No.
Someone went into a coma last campaign,
It's a lot of games. Do you got any games on your phone?
Yeah. So, alright, so yeah, you three, anything you'd like to do in the town?
Snot-nosed kid comes up and asks me that and boot him right in the face.
Does anything intrigue us?
Well, there's a whole town to explore you have no idea about.
Hey, little asshole intrigues me.
What about the store?
Which one? The food one?
Yeah.
Okay, you want to go to there?
Wait, do we... Okay, what is the currency?
We have pies. We have fries.
Go to the store.
I'm gonna go home and get in my sex dungeon.
No,
I'm
just kidding. Dude. So, okay, so you're going to the food store. Edward and Abrams, what would you like to do?
How do people make money here? Because they gotta pay for the,
You'd have to find someone who lives here?
I'll do that.
Yeah.
I suppose you could think about, the races as almost being a form of not so much it's sort of like a form of taxation.
Yeah,
because for one thing it's entertainment, but it's you get everyone in one place, so it's a good time to collect taxes.
Are you
anyway?
But how do they, if it's mandatory, they gotta pay money. Nobody leaves the town.
Yeah.
How do they make money?
Well, no one leaves the town permanently.
Oh, okay.
Like, people don't pack up and leave.
Okay.
Yeah.
Just getting excited over there.
So, to the food store with you. So, ting-a-ling, jingle jangle, the bell rings, and you instantly, you see this guy on a, there's like the counter, there's like the display shelves with all these sort of goods and stuff. And a guy with a bloody white coat on, and he's got the butcher's blade, just like, What do you want?
Well, this is my first day here. I just gonna have some questions.
Fresh meat, eh? I got fresh meat.
But it was
No, my daughter just died.
What do you got?
This animal I'm slaughtering just died. You want some?
Got anything that's
worth it? Everything's business to this guy.
What do you want?
Advice?
Just the
advice about life. About love.
Food for thought.
I just have some questions.
We're dealing with some liberal arts degree over here.
Well, I hate liberal arts degrees.
How do you make money in this
We put food in our bellies around these parts.
We don't like the poor here.
How do you make money? Well, it's pretty simple, my friend. You just gotta listen to that squeaky chair. Wait for the bird chime.
It's the call of opportunity.
Has arisen.
And, you see, you gotta deliver interesting goods. That's up to the seller to determine if it's interesting.
Okay. And that's it?
Yeah. Just trade for trade.
What happens? What about most of the people that started the camp? Like.
Well, they're either still living here or they're dead.
Okay.
In the ground.
What happens if you run out of money? Don't have any money to go to the mandatory races.
Then you're dead in the ground. Where you belong.
Understandable.
He's an enemy.
Who's this guy? Is this guy
the guy at the
store owner?
He's a mean person.
Yeah, the food shop.
Okay.
He's
being
kind of a dick.
What
do
you have to
say?
Well, slams it down into the chunk of carcass that he's carving up. And, on the left side, you got the cheap shit. You got canned goods. You know, you got your can of Spam. You got canned bologna.
Sam I am?
Yeah.
Canned bologna?
And, canned bologna. You know, you got your
bologna.
Vienna sausage.
Canned bread.
they have it. Canned
they have
bread.
It.
When's the bologna gonna come off the slicer there, bud?
And, So you got the cheap shit on there. On the other rack, get sort of the rarer goods. Get stuff like I haven't seen another one since. No one's been able to afford it. The last box of Hostess Twinkies. There are vegetables in the garden as well.
Twinkies.
Yeah. But of course, when the garden starts running low, we start selling it here.
We start cannibalizing.
Yeah.
Ooh. And,
Right now, the crop is doing at a half season, which is bad for me.
Hey, Wilson. This guy's name was Roger.
Starvation, so I can make my money.
He's hamburger now.
And, of course, right here, it says fine carcass. Fine pig.
Fine meat of undisclosed nature.
Okay.
Take our word for it.
Thanks for that. I'll come back when I have some more dough to deal out.
Well, that's good.
This guy here was a real pig. I hope he is a real pig.
I'm no charity case, so you're going to have to pay your way in. Got it?
Got it.
All right, now if you're not buying anything, get out.
In summarization, this guy is a big meanie head.
And, I'm assuming you presumably exit the store in a brisk pace.
Yes.
So, ding, ding.
I'm speedwalking.
Yeah, he goes back to chopping it up.
Poor Roger.
All right. So, is there anything you'd like to do before this night ends, or is that it for the day?
I'm going home.
I'm going. Going back. Wait a second. Do I have a roommate?
Currently, no. Actually, sorry.
Bachelor lifestyle.
Actually, Detroit walks up to you when you go to the apartments.
I could die Detroit's like, in your arms
so
tonight.
I was divvying out the rooms. There's a bit of a snag.
Snag.
You're gonna have to bunk with someone. I don't know how close you are to these people. So I'll give you the liberty of choice. There's the Brian gentleman. There's Philip. Philip. Oh, and Nick Parsons. He's, yeah. So you can bunk, yeah, I think those three.
Andrea. Yeah.
She's with you.
What? Oh, shoot.
And, those are the three people with apartments available. Oh, yeah.
I'll bunk with Philip.
Okay.
So it's Phil.
You probably use it. He looked a little unhinged.
He's yeah. Hi, I'm Dr. Phil.
Yeah.
Unhinged.
Unhinged.
Just don't let me know. I'm the mechanic. I'm not even supposed to be doing this shit. Lazy Sue didn't bother showing up, so
Lazy Sue.
Anyways, yeah, you're gonna have to talk to Gene Gavin if you got any problems. And good luck with that.
Start calling her Productive Sue, so that would be ironic.
Detroit starts chuckling. It's like, you're a good man, Abrams.
In the weirdest luck
and,
possible.
Anyways, yeah, so Philip's on the top floor of the second apartment, so your stuff's at the lobby, so any bag you had in the lobby, so you can just sell right in. Alright,
cool. I'll move all my stuff into Philip's room.
Okay, so you open up the door, and Philip's in the room, and he looks at you, he's like, what are you doing here?
I got assigned to you as your roommate.
We're room buddies.
We're bunking together.
Isn't that just wonderful?
Seems wonderful to me, too.
Oh my god.
It's a nice, relaxing home life here.
Sit next to any corpse you want.
How do I put this? Peanut gallery.
Oh, was that louder than I thought it was?
Yep.
That was pretty loud. Don't go in the laundry room.
Are the machines broken?
Yeah.
Alright.
Really?
They're broken. Does he not have to use Nick's?
Does he not realize this?
Down below.
Alright.
Don't go in there.
Okay.
See, okay. I'm gonna have so much fun killing him.
Don't, whatever you do, don't go in there.
Okay. Just make it a
They're really broken.
Don't open that door.
And actually, he opens up the door, and you can only hear a brief as he goes in and shuts the door. Yeah. And you hear a lock from the inside. So.
Yeah.
Welcome to your new room. So you're just gonna settle right in?
Yeah, I'll just settle. What sort of doors? What's the door to the laundry room like?
What's the door to the laundry room? It's a standard bolt lock.
Bolt lock, okay.
Gotta need a key.
On a scale of like.
One to suck.
Swinging saloon doors to Fort Knox.
It's a very firm and solid wooden door.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a solid province house door. Huh.
Very kickable.
All right.
Wood is quite the kickable material when turned into a door.
I'll unpack my stuff and sit on the bed.
Okay. And so with that, the first night has unfolded. Peanut Gallery, I'm assuming you're not doing anything?
Might jack off.
That Archie Digest, eh?
Well, Betty's pretty hot.
All right,
I'd pick her over Veronica any day.
Veronica's
Yosef
best girl.
Wanks in the back room.
Get out of here.
Betty's
oh,
my wife.
Wait.
Get out of town.
Can I talk to the receptionist? See if I can make this room unsterile?
Oh my.
You'd have to enter the play area.
Well, yeah.
The play, the play place at McDonald's.
The play
place.
I mean, you it's D&D, so you have to basically do anything.
Unless I'm
here to schedule a doctor's appointment. Sir, can you step into the ball pit?
Do I want to start to...
He has moved his office into the ball pit.
Put the gun down and step into the ball
pit. Step into
it. I'll wait another day.
They open up the back of the paddy wagon, some balls fall.
And so,
Oh,
well,
man.
Yeah, so yes, it's the new day.
It's
and,
a new day, yes.
Balls from like a ball pen.
Like a redneck ball pen.
Yes. Portable ball pen.
No red. Oh my god.
And, yeah. So, you hear a knocking on all your doors, except for you, Edward. And, so, Gene Gavin wants to meet with you and you.
You're in trouble.
And, he says, meet me at the infirmary. So, Yosef, we're going to need you to step up to the plate there.
Oh, do I?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just going to, like, tell Helen, hey, I kind of smuggled this gun in here. It's going to be in the drying machine.
Helen's like, okay.
Don't turn on the dryer.
Yeah. I guess I'll finish it.
Yeah, if you hear gunshots in the dryer.
Yeah. So, yeah. So he's like, so you guys are taken to the infirmary. And so Gene Gavin's like, now, I was talking with
I don't
Ray
mean to meet a nervous purpose.
He said you guys were pretty over on a, like, you know, overall scale.